In the first movie, Captain America, when you fell off the train, how did you survive?
What happened was, I was trying to break my fall with my left arm. Wasn't really able to do that, and so I fell and I knocked my head against a rock, and then next thing I know I open up and there were just a bunch of like lab coats around me.
Day number 37, of feeding my pet seagull to gain his trust. Today Steven showed up with only one leg. What happened, buddy?
I didn't think it was that noticeable.
You look like Lieutenant Dan.
I sold it for a Chrysler.
That's a good trade. Wait a minute.
Gotcha, bitch.
You are such a prankster. Let's get this room seagull ready. Sit tight, buddy. Almost ready.
Sick.
Come hither.
Hey, bitch.
Your table is all ready.
I am too shy.
Come on, buddy. I promise it's safe. You've got this, Steven. I believe in you.
I want to eat it so bad.
It's been an hour, my Legos are getting sleepy, and he's starting to look really sad.
I could cry.
It's okay, buddy. We all learn at our own speeds. Last piece.
It looks divine.
We can try again tomorrow, buddy.
Cool. Bye, bitch.
Bye, buddy. I can't wait for you to move in.
You know what she said to me? She said, you're a player, aren't you? And I bet you got hoes. I said, you don't know me like that. I just go with the flow. She said, you can't fool me like that. You're gonna...
Today, I'm showing my dad my college.
Yeah. This is nice.
Yeah. You like it?
I like it. Is that, do you know them? Is that your friend?
I don't know them.
You should meet them.
Nope, that's okay.
How about those people?
I don't know them either.
These guys walk around?
I don't know them.
God, introduce me to some people. Do you have any friends?
No. No.
Let's go make you some friends.
Stop. Please stop.
Okay, see how it says 4, 3, 2, 1?
Yeah.
You're only allowed to move one pen to make it 1, 2, 3, 4.
Do I have to move one?
Mm-hmm. To make it 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yes, I need something printed. Sorry. 2955.
You can only move one pin.
I don't know.
To make it 1, 2, 3, 4.
What do I do? I don't know. It's not possible.
You ready?
Yeah. But you moved that one and that one.
Are you a good liar?
Extend the first finger of your dominant hand, and now you've got 5 seconds to trace a capital Q on your forehead.
5, 4, 3, 2. You're
some
too slow.
Some people draw the Q in a way that can be read by somebody facing them, with the tail on the left side of their forehead. If you did that, then you tend to be aware of how other people see you. You're happy being the center of attention, and you're a good liar. Other people draw the cue so they themselves can read it, with the tail on the right-hand side of their forehead. If you did that, then you tend to be more of an introvert and not very good at lying. So if you want to gain a quick and fun insight into somebody, just ask them to draw a cue on their forehead.
When you have a date and your eyes are swollen, but you have a twin.
I don't know what to say. Dude, say anything. Where'd you get your peaches? Oh, I got my peaches out in Georgia. Yo, say that again.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
What is something that doesn't sit right with you, Ocean Edition?
What's up, y'all? I'm gonna do a voiceover on this one. Because I got a question. So a lot of people contribute NASA to a lot of conspiracy theories. You know, because NASA was supposed to be exploring the ocean when they first were introduced. And now they're all about space. People say that we haven't even explored all the ocean yet, but what if we have? Coming to the conclusion that that's why they want to get out of this world. But I have a different question. There's also a big talk about all the sea life that's dying. Dying from waste, oil spills, plastic, human consumption, human entertainment. This all is approved. So I wonder, are they killing off all the animals that we see to bring in the ones that we don't see, changing the ecosystem?
I love skimboarding in the summer along the beach, but I'm too impatient to wait for the ice to melt. Well, that hurt, but I can still walk, so while I'm here, I might as well try that again. I'm a little dazed and disoriented, and the ice feels extra slippery for some reason. Jumping on my board doesn't feel quite the same this time, as I must have hit my head pretty hard. Everything just feels like it's spinning and spinning and spinning, and wait a minute, where am I? I'm so confused.
I sit by myself, talking to the moon.
How messed up your sleep is.
Take a look at this scene. If you're not getting enough sleep, then you might experience very short blackouts called microsleeps. And these can stop you seeing what's right in front of your eyes. For example, did you spot the bus changing color?
No, you didn't, fatty, stop the cab.
Or the disappearing buildings. Or the child running towards the road.
What the F?
When we pressed the hand sanitizer, it's easy to break your wrist. Very pitiful. So, I invented this. Automatic squeezing hand sanitizer aid. The design is very human. We just need to put our hands under the sensor. Very easy to use.
Bro, I lost my dog.
Where'd it go?
On vacation, bro. I don't know. Come here. Hey, can you sign Mom's birthday card?
Sure. What should I write?
Merry Christmas, bro. What do you think? Come here. Come here.
This is really good. I never had this before. Is this your first time?
No, bro. It's my 10th time. Come here. Come here. Yeah, police. I think someone broke into my house. I'm hiding right now.
Are they in your house?
No, he's at yours. Yeah. Wait.
Do you know that straight men can have sex with men and not be gay?
Welcome to Facto Cap, where we test TikTok trends to see if they're real or bullshit.
Okay, so I'm sticking in.
Oh. All right. What do you think of this one?
I think it's successful. You feel gay?
No. Do you?
No.
Okay.
Cheese of truth. You are your best friend's crush. Awkward.
They don't. All of the underwater tunnels I know of are in fact underground tunnels. It's just that the ground is also underwater. Now that doesn't mean that there aren't complications here. This does make things harder. Depending on what the ground that you're drilling through is made out of, there are a lot of different problems that you potentially have to face. Particularly if it's just muddy river bottom, which it was for a lot of construction projects in like New York and Boston. If you're building a tunnel through mud, your problem is that the mud could just collapse and like the riverbed above you could just fall into the tunnel. So what you have to do is you have to pressurize the tunnel with a bunch of compressed air. It basically makes the entire tunnel like a really long balloon. But if there's a tiny hole in that balloon, it becomes a big hole and all that compressed air starts to like shoot up through the mud into the river. And this happened once. And a man, Marshall maybe, tried to stop it and he got sucked through the hole and ended up in the East River. And he lived.
Dad? Yeah? How do you make babies? What? How did you make me? You see this? Uh-huh. You see that little hole there? Uh-huh. What do you put in there? A straw. That's where you make babies. I'm pregnant? Yeah. Why are you crying? Why you act shook? I told you before.
I don't want to be pregnant.
Too late, honey. You're pregnant now. Close your mouth or the baby will get out of there.
Tell me something about yourself that sounds false, but it's 100%.
Yeah, so I can do a lot of these, and hopefully I will. There's a lot to me where you're like, oh, really? And I'm like, yeah, it's pretty crazy, but here it is. So yeah, here's one. This is just fresh in my mind, something I always like. It's a fun little joke I always like to make, but yeah, let's take a look. So this is a very real screenshot from my very real bank app. I would appear I owe about $100 billion. It's been fixed, but yes, this was a bank error. And I was like, hey, Chase, what's up? And they're like, not much. What's up? I was like, well, I think something's wrong. And they're like, well, it would appear you owe us money. And I was like, do I, though? They're like, well, that's what it says. I'm like, yeah, but I don't think I spent $100 billion this weekend. And they're like, yeah, you're right. That probably makes sense. I was like, oh, yeah, maybe? You think?
Keyshawn, do you think I'll look cute bald?
You know, you always look cute. Let me see.
Like this?
Oh, hell, wait.
No?
You look like one of these.
What the?
Oh,
are you
my
making
goodness.
Eggs? Are you serious?
Y'all look the same.
You look like your dad.
Hey, don't be talking about my damn daddy. My daddy cute.
Just breathe.
In college, I did my thesis on time perception, and I learned my favorite science story ever, which is how we learned that bees can perceive time. The experiment is pretty straightforward. A scientist put sugar water outside of a bee's hive every day at 4 p.m., and soon enough, the bees learn to leave the hive every day at 4 p.m., even when there's no sugar water. Therefore, these bees must be measuring and perceiving time. Whoa, 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 hold your horses. What if the bees are just doing something else, like measuring the angle of the sun? So they did the experiment again, in the dark this time, and the bees still come out at 4 p.m. Therefore, bees... Well, hold on, what if they're measuring the heat from the sun instead? These back and forths kept happening until they ended up recreating the experiment underground in a salt mine. And still, people were like, what if they're measuring the rotation of the Earth? How do we prove that bees perceive time? Until one scientist did the exact same experiment, not in a salt mine, but in Paris, and then flew the bees to New York City, where they left the hive, at 10 in the morning, because they had jet lag, because bees perceive time.
Testing Minecraft logic in real life, part 1. The first logic is placing a water bucket from height and taking no damage.
Let me know what you want me to do next.
Here's our water bucket that we're going to be using.
Here we go.
I took no damage. It's true, guys. Place a water bucket and you'll take no damage.
Can you say how are you? Can you say holy moly? Can you say oh yeah?
Take a pen and hold it between your teeth and make darn clear that it doesn't touch your lips.
and raise your eyebrows, you will create a facial expression which is sending signals to your brain that you are happy. And if you're ever like in a down mood, do this for 30 seconds and watch a video clip of penguins jumping into the water or falling off the ice, and you will feel better.
Anybody ever read the Q-tip box? Don't do it. It'll shake you to your very core. You read that box, you realize I've been cleaning my ears wrong for decades. Here's what it says if you've never read it before. The Q-tip box says this: do not insert Q-tip into ear canal. I was like, pardon me? Y'all, I've been cleaning my ears for 30 years, and by that I mean I stick a Q-tip all the way into my ear until I touch what I can only imagine is my brain. And then I twist it till I go cross-eyed. And I pull it out and pray there's not blood. That's how you use a Q-tip where I come from. But there's nothing to grab, so I let go.
Hey guys, can I take your order? Yeah, can I just get a Caesar salad and a Coke? Fucking Caesar salad, eh? Yeah, fucking giant. Excuse me? You want that tossed in fucking sour Skittles? What? Oh, I just expected you to want more food. And a Coke, you said, right? Yes, please. And you don't want to make that diet? No thanks, just a regular Coke. Fucking take a few years off your life. And for you, little buddy, can I get the chicken tenders and mac and cheese? You say that one more fucking time, normally? Chicken tenders and a mac and cheese. It's tenders. Tenders. And a mac and cheese? Yes, please. Could I also get milk? And you just fucking suck on your mom's tits. What? Nothing. Is that everything for you guys? Could I actually add a glass of wine? Why, you fucking depressed? Fucking should be. Look at the size of your fucking head. I'll go ring your orders in, okay? Absolute fucking behemoth. Excuse me?
Hello, what brought you into the ER today? My stomach hurts. Then why are you eating Cheetos? It helps calm my stomach.
Excuse me.
What?
Stop talking, please.
No. Or what?
Is she gonna stab me?
This is what happens when views and followers gets to your head. This makes
it's
me sick.
It's not who made it first, it's who does it better. Who gives a fuck about some little copy content? Like, I'm an actor. I'm not a writer. I'm not a fucking storyteller. You give me a script, I will fucking nail that shit. And I'm not gonna think of it, no. But I'm gonna make yours better. Or make yours, you know what I mean, good. Like, your shit is probably not as good, and that's why it's not performing well. Let me go on live, let's see how much shit I can get in the comments. For copy and content. Like, come on, man.
Your mom was so fat when Dracula sucked her blood, he got diabetes.
You got diabetes. Oh, yeah? Well, your mom's so fat, every time she steps on the scale, it says to be continued.
Okay, bet. Hey, Mom.
Yeah?
Can you step on the scale for me, please?
Why do you want me to weigh myself?
To see if it says to be continued.
Get back here, you little...
Scott, help me!
I'm back at my favorite spot to go ice fishing, and often I catch some pretty cool creatures here. First, you need to drill a hole with an ice auger big enough for a fish. Once that's done, drop your bait and hook into the hole. You want to jig around the rod to attract the interest of the fish down there. A fish could come at any moment, so even though I get comfortable, I have to stay alert. Here we go, I got a bite, and it feels big. Last time I caught a nice pike, but this feels much different. Yeah. What is this thing? I'm not sticking around to find out. Bye.
Hey, you on the right. I know your name.
No, you don't.
I do. Is it Micah?
How?
I feel like you look super familiar. Do you live on
sound like with this.
What the? Alright, I'm trying this. Let's get the reaction from my cat. Damn, I feel sorry already. Oh, baby.
Bro, like I'm dead. You killed me. I'm dead now. Boo. Bitch, I'm a.
We're doing the census challenge.
I don't want to play.
Close your eyes. Both eyes. Close both eyes.
This technology is too good.
Close your eyes.
I can't even keep see the. Okay.
What do you hear?
Lighter.
Now, what do you feel?
Hey! What kind of a game is this? You put ice, you trick me, you do the lighter, you put the ice and you make me foolish because I cried like as if my flesh was searing when it was just the ice cube.
What the hell happened to you?
Bro, I'm walking home and two dudes are beating up this kid in an alley, so I had to step in and help.
Are you serious, man? That's crazy. I'm like glad you helped out, man. That's dope.
I know, right? Little shit didn't stand a chance against all three of us.
What?
All right, guys, I'm gonna put one of these growy dinosaur things in this water and see how big it gets in like a week.
Fiona, African girl Adeola, body oddy shaped like cola. Back up, here, come closer. Vida loca, bullet high as a kite, never sober. Shit Python, hit him with a cobra. Free up my bro Casanova, free my bad man Paso.
I bless the rains down in Africa.
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 It's gonna take a lot to drag me away from you. There's nothing that 100 men or more could ever do. I bless the rains down in Africa. Gonna take some time to do the things we never had.
Ooh. Don't waste challenge.
Round one.
Round two. You're going down, buddy.
Round three.
Round number four.
Round five.
Round number six.
Yo, y'all actually still believe in gravity? Just walk on a wall, man.
Hey, Dad, people missed you.
Oh, hi, people.
So this little girl's probably like 12 years old or so, and she comes back from school one day and she asks her mom, she goes, Mom, what's an orgasm? And the mom says, I don't know, sweetie, I've never had one. Ask your dad.
Trust me. Your mom knows what an orgasm is.
Oh, God, what is wrong with you?
How far can deodorant be applied? This was a standard 3-ounce stick, and I was surprised at how well it actually covered the paper, and it seemed to be going a while. When I had to replace the paper, I noticed there were big clumps stuck in the tape, which means it could have gone even farther. It covered the second sheet just as well as the first, still going strong. This thing also made the room smell amazing, and at 1,037 laps, this thing went 1.7 miles.
Here are 4 things you probably do at the beach that are surprisingly deadly. First of all, swimming at night is such a bad idea. I've seen so many swimmers disappear, drown at night when they go swimming along the North Carolina coast. Also, your chance of getting bit by a shark increased by a large margin at night. 2, riptides. These are actually very dangerous currents that are kind of impossible to get out of, and people don't realize that. They try to fight them, and they end up drowning quite often. 3, swimming near piers. Overall, this is just not a safe idea, and as someone who goes to the pier every single year, I see people swimming near hooks, lobster traps, all sorts of dangerous and sharp things, and usually there's a bunch of sharks right next to them. 4, swimming with jewelry on, swimming near dolphins, or swimming with large schools of fish. All these things not only attract sharks, but other large predatory animals, and dolphins are not the cute, cuddly creatures you think they are, and they're actually unpredictable wild animals, so avoid all of these things.
Everybody has that one thing in their house that everybody thinks is so cool. Could be a hidden cabinet, little movie room, gadget, but ours is this.
The CDC and the FDA have just issued a joint statement recommending a pause in the use of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine in the U.S. The agencies say they are reviewing.
I know what they say.